this terrifying revolving door that's emerged between intelligence agencies and social media companies. Well, okay, so here again, you have reporters. They're not just talking. These aren't fake reporters. These are real people, real news services, Daily Mail. And they say, we've looked at this and we can name the number of CIA agents, FBI agents that have directly gone to work with Facebook, with Twitter, and with Google. And then they give us the names. Pick the story up. This is a remarkable story. Did you see this anywhere on national media?
No, that's what is so frustrating about this stuff too, because yeah, they found all these CIA agents, you know, former CIA lawyer, Gina Haspel, of them, Jim Baker, also one of them. Of course, everybody knows he was with Twitter until recently. Yeah. They realized, oh, wait a minute, get the hell out of here.
Yeah, he was with the FBI, CIA, and then went, yeah, exactly.
But what has happened here, which we've talked about with the FDA, with the SEC, the revolving door.
Right.
You take the people from industry, you put them in regulation, take the regulators, you put them in the industry. That's what's happening with this intelligence community.
Yeah.
We're sending our good agents. You now work at Facebook for some reason.
But you see, the problem is management knows it. They're cooperating. They're cooperating because they're getting money from the government in various ways, just like Amazon. Okay, Amazon gets these huge government contracts. These other folks do too. So Jack Dorsey, I guess, was thinking, well, wow, if I let Aaron Berman in, or no, Aaron Berman went with he went with Facebook, but this guy was he was the service manager. He was the security service manager for Facebook. He's the guy who said, this is a story we're going to allow. This is a story we're not going to allow. We're going to throttle this one back. We're going to throttle forward on this one. He was with he was a spook most of his life working for the CIA. Yeah. You have Deborah Berman. Well, she was a former intelligence analyst with the CIA, notoriously secretive in what she did. But she was working on her project with Facebook was to take misinformation and decide whether we should pull that misinformation or whether that misinformation is going to help us. So she decides, do we put it on, do we take it off? How many more people are there?
Oh, God, there's so many.
I mean, we don't have time to go through them.
You know, Chris Rose, who's political and counterterrorism analyst at the CIA, he went to Facebook. He joined them in March of 2020. Brian Weisbrand, CIA intelligence officer, he went with
LinkedIn.
Cameron Harris, he went to Facebook, but... Scott Stern.
But the point
also
is this. The point is this. We could go. This is a huge list.
Yeah, and we don't even have the whole list.
No, they came from the spook industry, and people like Jack Dorsey and Zuckerberg said, "Look, come to work with us." But it wasn't just. You see, there was something in it for them. Let's let this spook decide what we're going to put out there in the public. They're going to make the decisions. We're putting them in charge. But the rest of the story is when they did that, they benefited some way in all kinds of ways from the government. Just like take Amazon again. Go back to that story. What was it, $600 billion contract?
Yeah,
was it $600 billion?
A good portion of all the money they make actually comes from those government contracts. I think a majority of Amazon's profit, it's not from people buying toothpaste on their website. It's from these government contracts.
Yeah, so these freaks want to say, well, we're just looking out for the American public. No, they weren't.
No.
They were looking out for themselves. They were destroying everything we hold dear about the freedom of press in this country.
And you also have to wonder, too, what else did they get in return? Because a revolving door of this size with this many people from this one area of the government going to these exact same companies... There's a bigger relationship there, and I hope that gets flushed out because they get access, just like we talk about with media outlets that hire the former CIA people. It's because they want the access. So why did these groups need the access? That's a question we still need answered. Mm-hmm. We also know that these are companies that are still largely unregulated.
Yeah.
Facebook alone facing tons of lawsuits for monopolistic behavior. They want to be in good with the government because they did it with Obama. They did it with Trump. They're doing it with Biden.
Oh, it goes all the way back to Bush.
So no matter who's there, we're going to be your friend. We're going to give you what you want. In return, you don't touch us.
Right.
Leave us alone. We're your guys.
Don't hit us for monopoly cases. Don't, you know, say it's an antitrust case. Give us a break when you can. Even though Europe is killing us.
They are.
Europe is fining the hell out of us for doing all this illegal stuff. Don't do it in the U.S., and we're going to let your spook industry take control of this entity. That's exactly what's happened here. Federal Trade Commission has proposed a new rule to ban non-compete clauses for workers. Thank goodness. I know where this came from. It came from just old business. You come to work for us, we train you, and you can't go to work for anybody else after that. The problems, it's fraught with problems. First of all, there's no competition for wages. It keeps wages down. It keeps innovation down. Pick it up from there.
Yeah, and what we see a lot too now happening as the tech industry booms, a lot of these tech workers have to sign these clauses. You know, you cannot go and make your own tech company. You can't go work for our competitors. If you do, we're not going to share the secrets with you, which is what they use to try to scare them into submission. Mm-hmm. But it really does hurt competition. And to be honest, we have seen this so many years now, and this has contributed to the major problem with our healthcare industry. Mm-hmm. You get these doctors that basically have no choice but to sign up with a hospital corporation, and they have to sign saying, you will not open a private practice, you will not go work at the other hospital, you have to be with us, or you cannot work in this city anywhere.
You got to go somewhere else. It's a ridiculous old rule that we have allowed to stand. The only problem, I hate to say this, but if I'm analyzing this, I don't know that the FTC had authority to do it. I feel like probably it's going to fail. The U.S. Chamber of Commerce is putting huge money. You know, here again, people think the U.S. Chamber of Commerce is mom and pop warehouse or mom and pop store on the corner. It's not. U.S. Chamber of Commerce is 19 of the biggest mega corporations on the globe. So they're fighting this tooth and nail. They're saying, gee whiz, we're gonna lose trade secrets if we do that. We're gonna lose sensitive information. We're not gonna spend the time training employees if you make us do this, which is all ridiculous argument. But the point is, it's unfair. You know, first of all, it's certainly unfair. And it does, if you think about it, it holds wages down.
Yeah,
because that person who's working for this corporation may say, well, right down the street, they're going to pay me $10 more an hour. Well, I'm sorry, Joe, you can't go there. And if you do, we're going to sue you and we're going to sue them too.
And you make a great point here too, because I thought the same thing reading through this. This is a wonderful proposal. It would be great to have it go through. It's going to get killed in court.
Yeah.
If it makes it all the way to our corporate-controlled Supreme Court or any of the corporate district courts, there is no way they are going to let this stand.
It
will die, unfortunately, but it's a step in the right direction.
Well, that doesn't mean Congress can't take care of
right.
it. You see, they won't, again, because, again, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce are thugs. They're absolutely thugs. And I don't know what it takes the American public to understand it, but this is a great example. It should happen. It's not going to happen. They're going to lobby it to death. They're going to put more money behind it, because they're going to argue that the FTC simply doesn't have any written authority, either apparent authority, to be able to do this.